YouTube, how are you living? How you living? Thanks for tuning in. I got something real different for you today. I know, sometimes this game makes you want to throw your controller out the window. Man, sometimes it makes you want to smack your guinea pigs. But getting better at anything always comes with a process. You know, a great quote someone told me is that the will to win, the desire to succeed, the urge to reach your full potential, these are the keys that will unlock the door to personal excellence. Today, I wanted to take a look at different clips of gameplay to give tips to the average player just trying to get better and have fun at the game. So, let's dive right into it. The number one thing before getting into gameplay would have to be settings. I cannot stress that enough. Even myself, I'm always fine-tuning my settings, trying to perfect what's good for me. The game is constantly changing. You should as well. When you watch these pro players, you might get confused or overwhelmed by all the fast movement, building, techniques, but ultimately, they're just performing highly in the most comfortable aspect thanks to their own settings. So don't always copy people's settings to the T, always put yourself first, go to like playground mode or creative and give yourself 30 minutes and keep changing your settings, your sensitivity, keep fine tweaking different things until you're completely comfortable, or at least for the most part. Practice building, practice editing, play with friends, all of it is for fun, and it takes little to no time. Trust me, you're probably overthinking it. I know for myself, I'm always thinking like, I don't really care for the game, I'm not getting paid for this, so how much time am I really gonna put into it? But then when I die, I'm like, crap, I really wish I knew how to, you know, do that edit play or etc. So yeah, do it for fun, play with your friends. When you play with your friends, times, you know, time flies. So number two, you knew it was coming. It has to be landing. Landing is the most important in an aspect in a game. It can start you off with good guns, good placement, good kills, or it can have you, you know, heading down. So this guy right here doesn't even see me coming. I'm pickaxing her to death. She doesn't even realize. A lot of people underestimate pickaxe damage. They used to do it a lot in earlier seasons, but now people just don't expect it. They're just too busy rushing. So you can definitely take advantage of people not paying attention, flying in, just trying to get to the chest as fast as possible, and not realizing that they're getting pickaxed. There's so many times where I died thinking like, you know, I can get to the chest and I'm opening the chest and someone's just pickaxing me. Next thing you know, I'm on the ground, you know, so definitely utilize everything. So right now I hear this guy trying to break through the wall. You know, he hears some commotion. So I'm waiting for him and I put the wall down immediately and shoot him in the stomach and he's dead. This hippie is gone like out like a light. So his mistake is he obviously didn't know I was like right there and he didn't put the wall down fast enough. You know, obviously I was waiting for it. So he was just sitting there confused the entire time, just, you know, thinking it's his wall. I edited out the top and just, you know, got the easy kill. So let's get into number three. Shout out to all the console players, PS4, Xbox. Yo, you really have to abuse that 100% accuracy that we have. As you can see in some of these clips, this guy, I don't know what he was doing. He was just chilling. I guess trying to do a med kit, it looks like. But you definitely want to abuse that. You're going to see me get on one knee sometimes and just get that 100% accuracy and just take people's heads off, hitting them with headshots. Thanks to my settings, you know, I'm allowed to control my, you know, when I spin around, I'm allowed to control that really well. This clip shows you exactly what I mean. I'm coming up to help my teammate. I see this guy jumping around. I'm not sure if he sees me. I'm trying to get this headshot. He sees me, I push, he push, but I wait for him, hit him with a couple headshots, and he was just done. You know what I mean? A lot of people get very cocky, especially on console. You know exactly what I'm talking about. People get really cocky. They just want to push and jump, and you know what I mean? Jump in your face. They think they got you, but they don't. You know, as long as you hit your shots, you know, people are going to go down. Just make sure you put aim over everything. You know, not over building,
guys, don't forget
but definitely put aim in front of a lot of things.
Yeah, I already knocked that one.
So in this clip, I'm playing with a couple randoms and some of my friends as well. Soapy's my boy. But I really, this entire game, I was so confused. You know, I'm trying to carry as much as I can. I'm carrying. And there's these people that are underneath all these builds, and I'm not sure. See, I'm like trying to, like, you know, probably put a track down, and all of a sudden I see two people with lightsabers. This is like a nightmare being that close to them. So I try to go around and I see another guy is just so confusing, and then he drops. But right here I just wanted to highlight how to counter lightsabers. You just have to push. She gets knocked back into a storm, takes chunk of damage and just gets destroyed. Teammate comes back out. Oh man, same thing. Gets destroyed again. Lightsabers are good for close quarters, but if you're gonna use them, I think you should definitely look into the best way to use them. So this last guy's in this box. I don't know why I got confused. For some reason, I thought the snipe came behind me. You know, my boy Soapy's telling me to take the win. I push this guy. I want to take the wall, but I knew I didn't have to. There it is. A little easy win. That's just one of many, and one of many now just for myself, but it's going to be a lot for you as well. I really hope I helped you with this video. Gave you some type of information, something to work off of, something to improve onto. And remember, as long as you get frustrated, it's okay. It's always a process. You know, when you wake up tomorrow, you're going to be a lot better. And please, this is my first video doing something like this, and I would love if you subscribe, comment down what you think about the video, or you know, if you use your aim reticle, if you use all any of these tips, or if any, and you know, you can share your own tips if you would like. I'm definitely welcome to all those things. So I hope you enjoyed. Subscribe and like.